Hey, hey, Wallace here with another update on the Quail account. As you can see, I've hit level 19, so we are progressing quite okay. The progress on that level will of course slow down as we get higher, but for now it's going quite well. A quick update on the progress as a whole. I finished Temur Desert and then is now battling my way through the Rofagos ruins. Well, the difficulty has risen a bit. The fire werewolf can hit quite hard and have a bit of self-healing. So I'm trying to level up my units a little more before progressing. And we can do some of that today as well. One place I've actually done quite well, I've cleared the dragons B1 and B2. I didn't actually think I could do B2, but I could. It's not a 100% success rate, but it's quite high actually. So I have been getting some of the more special runes. Not enough to make a set yet. I can just show you. You see one Nemesis rune, a Shield rune, and a Vampire rune. Actually, it was a legendary Vampire rune, so only 2-star though, because I think you can get. Did I get a 3-star from one of them? No, that's a 2-star too. And the Shield rune was also a 2-star. Yeah. So probably only 2-star. You might have a small chance of a 3-star. But we are getting them. I actually think making the shield set would be very good. Maybe instead of one of these energy sets, you will make a shield set or the blade set. This unit really does not benefit from a blade setting. So, well, I need another rune for that first, so that have to wait. In the monster department, I've tried to level the units where we 4-starred in the last one. That meaning being Wind Griffin and Shannon, which has been progressing quite good. Also the Water Garuda. And we can actually upgrade the unit a bit more. We can awaken the Fire Hellhound, so we get access to this new skill, which buffs the attack power and critical rate for all allies. So that's pretty good. I've been farming for that in the Fire Dungeon today, so let's do that. It's a really good buff to get. The only downside of this unit is it's very squishy. Can't really take any damage, but it's good. That leveled up the base stats of the unit as well, so it will in essence hit harder. I've also leveled up its skills. I've used a good bunch of unknown skulls and was lucky enough to get some hellhounds. So I've used those to boost his skills. Also, Shannon has gone up a few skill levels, and the Water Garuda as well. So those units have progressed quite good. Well, it will be a few days, right? But the next aim is to awaken Shannon. Simply because it's one of the easier units to awaken in the beginning. Mid-level essences are not really easier at this stage to farm, and to awaken, let's say, the Fire Magical Archer, it requires 20 mid essences. So, well, it can be done, no question. Also, the Fire Inferno, which requires 15. So, It's definitely something to aim for, but for now we'll stick to the easier units. Also because we get access to quite good skills that also a buff unit. Oh, I think, did the shop just update? Yeah, let's see if we get anything. Anything we can use? Nope, not really. There are, of course, 4-star runes here and there, but I haven't been investing in them simply because I think they're too expensive at the moment. On another note, I have also been doing some PvP since the last reset, and I've bought some of the glory shop buildings down here. You have the monstrous plant, which lowers the cooldown of energy, and the other two buildings here are actually just upgrades for the mana generating buildings up here. They can store more mana and they regen it faster. So that's an addition as well. I've also expanded the monster storage or capacity to up to 50, so I can hold more monsters while I use those unknown scrolls. So that's good as well. And on a final note, we can't have one of these updates without doing a mystical scroll. I was actually lucky enough when I cleared Dragon's B1 to get one. So it seems that this current pace, I'll actually have one mystical scroll a day. If that continues, I'll be happy. But it probably will not. So, well, without any further ado, let's just do this and see if we get a lightning summon. And we did not. We did not. We got a fire griffin. Well, I have to figure out how to use that most effectively. I'm not sure I'm gonna use it. I'm one way or another, I'm gonna feed it to my wind griffin for a skill up. Question if to do it now or 4-star it first and then use it to 5-star the wind griffin. That's time will tell. So, still no rare units for this account. We'll of course continue to see where we can go. When we hit, as you can see, we have 660 crystals now, so only 90 to go. And if we hit level, I hope I get to 750 crystals before then. But when we hit level 25, we'll get, what is it? I think it's 150 crystals for achieving level 25, something like that at least. But that's it for. Oh, by the way, did I do the event? Always me this refund event started a few days ago. Or was it yesterday? A few days, I can't remember. No, didn't do it today. If you use 50 energy, you can just press collect and you'll get it back. If you use 10,000 mana, you can press this and get it back. So that's pretty good. But for now, that's it. We'll see you for the next update tomorrow. Bye bye.